Assalamu alaikum. It's nice to see you all again as we continue with our series of bringing the divine names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala into our daily lives to improve our relationships with our spouses and with our children. Today, the name that we're going to explore is the name of Al-Aziz, which means the one with honor or the most honorable. Now, when we think of honor, we often equate honor with the honor applied towards the marriage vows or the honor within the marriage relationship, honor towards husband and wife. But honor also extends in the family realm to our children. It's frequently heard that in the past, children honored their parents in a way that was much more respectful than what we see today. We'll often hear that the level of respect shown to the parents, the level of honor towards the parents was incomparable, maybe 10 years, 20 years, 30 years ago to what it is today. Why is that? What is it about the aspect of honor that our children today may be losing sight of or may be having difficulty with? It's undoubtable, of course, that we live in a world where our children are consumed and bombarded with really self-motivation. We've got our iPhones and our iPads and our iTunes and iPads and surrounded in a world that's very narcissistic. That narcissism often allows our children to feel like the world is all about pleasing them. The world is all about their nafs and their desires. And this, of course, is a very negative path in which our children might go down, because it is a path that leads to a giving in of desires, a feeding of desires, a feeding of the nafs, and a growing of arrogance and ego. So bringing honor back into our lives, bringing honor back into our children's lives, begins with allowing our children to experience what it really means to have that parental respect, what it means to not say uff to our parents, as the Quran commands us, what it means to elevate our parents to a place where the connection with them is one that is built upon honor and respect. You know, when we think of Al-Aziz, oftentimes another chapter of the Quran also comes to mind. And it's the chapter of Surah Yusuf, where we are given the narration of what happened to the Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam, when the wife of Al-Aziz, and Al-Aziz was the chief minister of Egypt at the time, when his wife Zulaykha put Sayyidina Yusuf, the Prophet Yusuf, into a very compromising situation. Now, Prophet Yusuf as a child experienced a great deal of jealousy from his brothers. And in that jealousy, that sibling rivalry, it caused them to act in a way that, of course, was incredibly detrimental. In throwing their brother into the well and coming home to their father and saying that he had been eaten by a wolf, the brothers acted out their sibling rivalry, of course, in a way that showed no honor, in a way that showed no respect. And in lying to their father, even as he wept in front of them, they continued to live out that life without honor, that act without respect. And in the well, when Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam was brought up in a bucket by a caravan, a man who was a part of a caravan that was trading, the man was taken aback and thought, wow, this is my lucky day. I now have someone that I can trade in as a slave or sell as a servant. And so the Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam was sold to Al-Aziz, the man who was the chief minister of Egypt. The man grew to love Sayyidina Yusuf because he was kind, he was compassionate, and he had nur on his face, light on his face, and he was honorable. His actions always maintained honor. And then there came a time when Zulaykha, the wife of Al-Aziz, began to covet Sayyidina Yusuf and to feel that she had every right to seduce this gentleman who she saw was honorable, who she saw had light and respect in his character. And yet in a situation, she reached out to him and pulled the shirt off of the back of Sayyidina Yusuf. And in that moment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent help to the Prophet Yusuf in the form of the husband of Zulaykha, Al-Aziz, opening the door with one of his relatives by his side. And in that moment, in the questioning of Sayyidina Yusuf, the relative looked at the shirt and said, if the shirt is ripped from the back, then it is Zulaykha who has seduced him. But if the shirt is ripped from the front, then we'll know that Zulaykha is telling the truth and that it was Yusuf who initiated. And of course, the shirt was ripped from the back because Yusuf was an honorable man. And in eventually saving him from this trial, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserved the honor of Yusuf by allowing him to spend time in a prison. And for us, when we look at our daily lives, sometimes what seems like a prison can actually be salvation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes in trying to maintain our honor, sometimes in trying to maintain the honor of our families, we may find ourselves in a situation that seems very difficult. Maybe under financial duress, maybe under difficulties with family, maybe in difficulties at work or in other realms. But in the end, it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Aziz, who protects our honor, who gives us that sense of honor, and who we look to as the most honorable always. So I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keeps that izzah, that honor in our lives, and protects our honor for us, for our family, and really integrates in our children's lives that sense of honor towards their parents. Jazakum Allahu khair, and I look forward to seeing you tomorrow as we speak about the next name of the 99 names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Assalamu alaikum.